All right, here we go. Hi, Joe for Jaspy's Hobbyland here. A little under the weather today, but we're still breaking on here on the 21st. Pick your team, a number six from jaspyshobbyland.com. Contenders football, all 12 boxes. Get a hot chocolate, get an adult beverage if you're an adult, and settle in and get ready for this break. Thanks to Matt with Last Spot Mojo on the Dolphins, and here's everybody else. Either way is fine, Stace. All right, here we go. So, hello to everybody on Breakers.tv and the YouTube, 12 boxes of this stuff. 5 to 6 autographs per box, ladies and gentlemen. So you are going to be looking forward to 60 to 72 autographs up in this. So good luck to everybody. This is not a clean box case on opening here. Whatever. Are you serious? Come on, man. Unbelievable. Haven't done contenders in a while. Oh, I see what happened. All right. Okay, so there's all 12 boxes right there. Big thanks to everybody who joined us yesterday for the NFLPA Panini GTS rookie closeout. It was pretty fun to hang out with some NFL players. Shout out to Tyler Lockett, not Tyler Lockett, Tyler Boyd, my bad, and Kenneth Dixon for hanging out with us and busting open some cards. You can see all the videos on our website. I think Nick got to hang out with Tyler Lockett was last year. I think Nick got to hang out with Michael Thomas, I think, yesterday. Who else did he hang out with? Some other players. But it was a lot of fun. So thanks to that. So this is pick your team number six from jaspyshobbyland.com, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for grabbing your teams in this. I think we're giving away two Super Bowl squares after this break. I'll double check that before we start. Gonna open up all the packs first. This is box one. At the end of every box, I'll be doing a quick recap. So if you're watching a replay on YouTube, be sure you can fast forward to the end of every box. You'll miss all the lovely conversation where we go off the rails sometimes, but you'll miss the conversation. But you can see the hits at the end of every box. No vet base ships, but I don't think anybody really wants the vet base out of here. The only variations in short prints are rookie, so you'll be getting all of those anyway. So good luck to everybody. Pick your team number six. Well, let's talk about it, folks. Tomorrow, a couple big games will determine who goes to the Super Bowl. Who does everyone have? Packers at Falcons, Pittsburgh at New England. What do you guys think? Let's talk about it. Dano, what's going on, man? Which version of Mike Thomas? Michael, it was the Saints edition of Michael Thomas. He was there. Saw Alex Collins wandering around. Ricardo Lewis was very nice. Jordan Howard looked very, very busy. But he chit-chatted with us for a little bit too. Michael Thomas was a little grumpy. Well, Michael Thomas was a little grumpy. And Alex Collins apparently was very cool, says the boss man. Everyone's saying, AZ Cards Chad, what up, man? Says the ATL. Stacy, of course, says the ATL, and she says Patriots. We got Swag Gaming saying Steelers over Pats, apparently. Falcons Steelers, says Jason McKee. Packers, of course, says Travis, of course. And hopefully Steelers. Patriots and Packers, says Sam. So, all over the place. Everyone's all over the place. Well, I think we're gonna see for I'm a big Raiders fan, as everybody knows. I think for a neutral fan like myself, watching I think any combination of those teams, I think, would be exciting to see in the Super Bowl. All right. Blake Bortles leads us off. So, like I said, all these base cards won't ship, but stuff like this will ship. This Malik Collins right here. Autograph going out to the boys. Jeremy Tillman with the Cowboys. I'll set this right up here. We can kind of recap those a little bit later. I'm gonna fly through all these base cards. So all this vet base, not gonna ship. This guy will ship. Delvin Bro. right? It's French. Go Saints. That'll go out to Matthew Viss. This stuff will ship right here. So these round numbers I'll randomize left and right. These will not ship. We're just going to toss them over there. Wait, did I miss any of the other inserts? I don't think I did. I don't think that was that round numbers was our first one. Yeah. See you, boss man. Stuff like this will ship. Rookie of the Year. Jared Goff was there. We didn't get to meet him, though. Tyreek Hill. So all these gridiron instant auto or whatever stuff, digital card stuff, we will ship because we're nice. Adjust the camera just a teens right here. MVP contenders, Jeremy Langford. Really? I don't know about that. But, okay. That's what Panini thinks. That's like your opinion, man. This edition of Michael Thomas. Dano is the one that was there. Bossman says he was a little grumpy. Touchdown tandems. Well, for the Steelers to even have a chance, Big Ben has to not be road Big Ben. He needs to be I'm playing at home Big Ben. And that will, of course, help Antonio Brown. I think Le'Veon Bell will still go off, though. Either way. Braxton Miller. And our next autograph, Eric Swoop. All right, look at him swooping in for the catch. You stay here for the jokes, folks. You come for the break, stay for the jokes. He's round, once again, left-right randomizer on that one. There's downtown Antonio Brown right there. And Robert Kelly. I think a lot of you guys had him on your fantasy teams towards the end of the season. There is a break lineup. We are doing contenders right now. And then limited football seven is after this. And then whatever after that. So nothing's really backed up except for that limited football number seven, which is from a fresh case. There's MVP contenders, the famous, 74 out of 99. Nice insert there, don't need that. Let me adjust this a little bit. And we've got Kenyon Drake. Nice, out of 199, playoff ticket autograph for the Dolphins. Last Spot Mojo strikes again, Matt Colley. With the Last Spot Mojo. 80% of the time, Last Spot Mojo hits 100% of the time. True story. Chris Jones. Cracked ice. Nice. 20 out of 24. Chris Jones for the Chefs. Going out to Travis Craig. Love the look of that cracked ice. Looks pretty sick, as the kids call it. It's pretty lit. Kids say that too. All right. That is box number one. So, some nice autographs here. There you go. There's your auto recap. Then we got that numbered card as well. Next box. Swag Gaming says, I'm glad Antonio Brown didn't get suspended. I'm sure the Steelers are glad too. I think that would have been a Steelers decision to suspend the player, right? Not a league decision, so I don't think the Steelers were going to suspend Antonio Brown for the AFC Championship. That just wouldn't happen. All right, next box. I'm going to open up all these packs first. I think if we talk AFC first, let's see here. AFC, Pittsburgh. I think it all depends on the performance of Ben Roethlisberger. I think he definitely has has kind of weird home road splits. You know what I mean? So that becomes an issue. Now Ben's road. Road play is often shaky. I know Antonio Brown's going to get his, right? Le'Veon Bell will get his. But they got to go into New England. And they got to go into New England. They got to try to beat the Patriots. That's tough. It's a tough matchup. Patriots offense is very strong, obviously. Defense is pretty good too, right? But listen, I don't think the Patriots have faced a kind of offensive power in a long time, if not all season, but in a long time. They haven't seen someone like him, you know? Someone like Ben Roethlisberger, someone like Le'Veon Bell, a big offense, you know, to challenge them. So it's a challenge. It's going to be a challenge. There you go. Adam K is right there. He's saying you're right. The Patriots have not beaten a good quarterback all season. Well, there was that Seahawks game, but it's not like Russell Wilson has been traditional Russell Wilson this season. But aside from that, yeah, I mean, what's the last big name quarterback the Patriots have had to face and defeated? So it's not going to be a walk in the park for the Patriots. You know, I think a lot of Patriots fans are just like, oh yeah, you know, like Patriots are gonna totally beat down the Steelers. It's gonna be a walk in the park. They're gonna go right into the Super Bowl, no question about it. I think there's some questions about it, you know? I think there's some questions about it. I don't think it's gonna be as easy as some Patriots fans would like to think. There's Ronnie Stanley going out to the Ravens. That'll be for Joe Howard. I pull Scrubs with that one. Oh, some points. We'll randomize that to one person in the break. So yeah, it's the defense. That's gonna be a big issue for them. How are they gonna handle all that? But once again, you know, Ben Roethlisberger has to not play like road Ben Roethlisberger. So if Big Ben is on his game, then that's gonna be an exciting game. I think both matchups should be exciting. There's Johnny Holton for my Raiders. That'll go out to Oakland Raiders. It goes at Jason McKee. There's the round numbers right there. Once again, we'll be randomizing those. There's Robert Kelly again. Another one for the Redskins. Michael G with the Redskins. Nice. We saw him perform pretty well toward down the stretch, right? Big player kind of taking over the Redskins rushing attack, which is good. Balanced out that offense. There's Khalil Mack. Here's a beast right here out of 249. Nice one. One of my favorite players on the Raiders. And we've got Leonti Carew. Rookie roundup. Nice. 22 out of 25. On card autograph for Matt and the Dolphins. Last spot Mojo again. Doing well. A couple autos already. And then we've got... what? Derek Watt. Cracked ice. Nice. That's 1 out of 24. Derek Watt cracked ice. Rory might like that one. I think Rory PC some Derek Watt Chargers. So Jeremy Merle, if you go to our Facebook group, you might have a buyer for this already. If you're intending to sell. I don't want to make that assumption. All right. Nice box. So you got another cracked ice popping out of here. Rookie roundup. So those are all the teams that hit. There we go. All right, and we'll randomize these points off to one person. And there's my boy Khalil Mack, playoff ticket. All right, next box. Travis is asking, hey, safe to say the Patriots have the coaching advantage, though, right? Well, I think Bill Belichick has certainly demonstrated for a very long time that he is an excellent coach. I like Tomlin. I like Tomlin in spite of what Terry Bradshaw says. I like Mike Tomlin a lot. I think he's more than just a cheerleader, as Terry Bradshaw said. I think Mike Tomlin's a great coach too. But Bill Belichick is one of the best. So if you kind of break down each sort of sector of the game, coaching, I guess you would give the edge to, in the AFC Championship, you'd give the edge to Bill Belichick, right? Quarterback. It's got to be Tom Brady at home, right? He definitely gets the edge on that. Running back. I mean, got to be Le'Veon Bell, you know. Wide receivers. It's got to be Antonio Brown. Edelman's pretty good though, obviously. Never can underestimate Julian Edelman. I guess Ladarius Green for the tight end position. I think Ladarius Green is coming back, right? I think he's out of concussion protocol. He's been practicing this week. Or is it concussion protocol? Some injury or something like that. But so I guess Steelers will have Ladarius Green back. That could be a interesting twist to the game. Jesse James as the Pirates tight end, or Pirates as the Steelers tight end as well. A little under the weather, so not as sharp today as I usually am. And then defense. Now the Steelers have a young defense, right? A lot of speed. They fly around all over the place, big hitters and whatnot, but still a little on the young side. I wonder if that is something that Bill Belichick and Tom Brady can take advantage of, you know? I must admit, I don't know too much about this, the Patriots defense, to really compare. Who has the edge on the defense, folks? You guys tell me. Who has the edge on the defense? Patriots or the Steelers? There's Ronnie Stanley for the Ravens going out to Joe Howard. I pull scrubs. That's his team, Ravens. Round numbers, which will randomize. Playoff ticket, that's a numbered card, so that will ship. Matt Forte out of 249. Bengals card saying Steelers have the edge on the defense. There's Tremaine Pope for the Jets. That auto goes to Adam K. There's Blake Martinez for the Packers. Packers will go to William Thomas. We'll send that Trayvon Boykin out too. Jacoby Brissett, autograph. Nice one for the Patriots. Speaking of the Patriots, goes out to Michael G. Nice one. So if Bengals card's the only one saying that the Steelers have the edge on the defense, then if that's the case, you know, then it really just comes down to quarterback play at that point. Now, you know, we all know what Tom Brady can do. There's Trevor Davis. We'll talk about the NFC in a little bit. We all know what Tom Brady can do week in, week out. But like I said before, Big Ben, the storyline has been there's no Spence for the Buccaneers. That'll be for Jerry. Now, everyone's been talking about this week, you know, Big Ben, road Big Ben and home Big Ben are two different Bens, you know. So if Big Ben can have a game, could be a long day for that Patriots defense then. Saw Broke with Kenneth Dixon yesterday. If you watched our videos yesterday, we did a few boxes of limited football with Kenneth Dixon. He was really nice. All right, I think that's it for this box. Oh, we got DeAndre Hopkins here at the end. 96 out of 99 championship ticket. It's a good one. That'll go out to, who are the Texans in this one? That'd be Arthur. There you go, Arthur. It's a start. All right, so a couple numbered cards, Jets, Texans. And then we have some autographs. We got Buccaneers, Packers, Patriots, Packers, Jets, and Ravens. Nice one there. Next box. Well, what about the NFC Championship, folks? Who has, who do you have in the NFC? Green Bay Packers traveling to Atlanta to face the Falcons. Who do you guys have in that matchup? Bengals card saying, Big Ben never has problems in Cincy. If only they were in Cincy. So I know we had some mixed opinion here, but Packers going into Atlanta. Sebastian says pack all the way. What does everybody else think? It's going to be, I don't think that's going to be, that's another, see, both games are really great. I'm looking forward to both games. I'm feeling a little under the weather, so I can't wait to maybe like order some soup, you know, maybe some junk food. And just lie in bed and just watch football all day long. Travis says Packers. He's like Packers. Aaron Rodgers can make any wide receiver great. He may have to make any wide receiver great, Travis, because he has a banged up wide receiving core. Is Jordy Nelson gonna play? If he does, could he be more than just a decoy? I don't know. Jason McKee, Dano saying no pack, no. Jason McKee says Falcons are going to poop on that third string secondary. That secondary is banged up. And when you got Matt Ryan performing like an MVP and you got Julio Jones, even with turf toe, Julio Jones just doing Julio Jones things. Even a 75% Julio Jones is 100% better than a lot of other teams. I think it'll still be a shootout, though. Yeah, Travis saying Jordy Nelson, Devontae Adams, and Geronimo Allison are all questionable. Well, time for the Cook era to begin, Travis. AZ Cards Chad. Chad saying it's going to be a shootout. No defense on either side. 44-40 Falcons at home. Yeah, Falcons getting the home edge. I think they're getting the home spread, right? I think they're getting -3 plus a point, plus another point. So I think it's Falcons -4, I believe, is the line. There's Von Bell, Saints. Saints auto going out to Matthew Viss. Save that. Round numbers card. We'll randomize that later. Flying through all the veteran base that we're not shipping. But we will ship another Johnny Holton autograph to the Raiders. That's the second one for Jason McKee. I think it will be a shootout, that is for sure. We should see a lot of points scored, a lot of lead changes. I mean, maybe that NFC game, points which we'll randomize. I think that NFC Championship game is going to be one of those games where It's gonna come down to whoever has the ball last. It's gonna be one of those games, isn't it? What do you guys think? I think it could be that. Oh, we'll send this out too. I think it could be that. I think it could be whoever has the ball last may be the winner of that game. It's gonna be one of those games. That's good for a casual fan like me. There's Eli, apple of my eye. Rookie ticket. Is he the apple of the Big Apple? Dave Marr with the New York Football Giants. Nice. Von Miller, MVP contenders. Drew Brees, 127 out of 199, MVP contender. I mean, maybe if he had a winning team, possibly. This guy throws like 5,000 yards like it's nothing. Oh, awesome Bengals card. Nice.
I hope so too. There's another Raider. Nice. 24 out of 99 on card auto championship ticket. DeAndre Washington. My Raiders.
DeAndre Washington had a really nice season as a rookie. Nice rookie season. Goes to Jason McKee. There you go, Jason. Hugh Jackson. Former Raiders coach Hugh Jackson. Cleveland Browns. Going out to Sebastian. Joey Bosa definitely had a great year. Todd Gurley. MVP contenders. Could have been. I think maybe with a new coach, he might be back. With a new coach, I think will work wonders for that entire Rams offense. I mean, they certainly can't be any worse than they were last year. All right. Here were your autographs out of there. So the Browns, Sebastian getting a Hugh Jackson coach autograph. That's pretty cool. Coach's ticket, it says. Nice DeAndre Washington, Giants, Raiders, and Saints. Nice one. All right, next box. Oh, yeah, and there was that MVP contenders card as well. All right, next one. Good luck. Ronbo looking for that early complain mojo. Yeah, it's pretty early to complain. 5 in here. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40 autographs to go. Ron, 40 autographs to go. Come on, Arthur. 40 autographs to go. At least. 40 autographs to go. A lot of these boxes have 6 autographs in there. Raiders rigged? Oh, unbelievable, says Arthur. Arthur thinks because of my Raider Joe mojo, it's rigged towards Jason McKee and the Raiders. Wait till all those Texans start coming out, then what will people say? Well, NFC championship. So people are divided between the Falcons and the Packers, it seems like. Everyone seems to agree that it will be a shootout. Coaches. Who has the edge on coaches? That could be interesting. You know, Kyle Shanahan has been a pretty popular pick for head coaching jobs. You know, that Falcons coaching staff, especially on the offensive side of things, really changed things for Matt Ryan. There used to be, you know, Matt Ryan used to just kind of sling the ball around. Julio Jones will get like his 1 million yards, you know, and a zillion catches, but Falcons would still lose the game. But over the last couple of years, the Falcons have really started tightening things up. Matt Ryan is probably could win the MVP, I think. You know, he has really turned things around, has been consistent from start to finish. And I think that's been pretty impressive. Atlanta coaches have been able to use both Devontae Freeman and Tevin Coleman evenly, which is also good, right? I mean, being able to use that kind of two-headed monster throughout the season, use them effectively, keep them fresh, that's been pretty smart. Julio Jones is Julio Jones, obviously. I mean, you know, even with turf toe battling, you know, that all season long, doesn't seem to matter. He'll still go off when he plays, and you know he's going to play on Sunday. And then you've got some other solid receivers like Mohamed Sanu, Taylor Gabriel, kind of spreading out the field. Working well. Austin Hooper, the tight end on the Falcons, he's been playing pretty well. So they're clicking pretty well on the offense. All right, next box. Pick your team 6 contenders, full case
Just talking a little football, breaking a little football. It's what we like to do here. We'll ship those out. And our first autograph, hey, speaking of the Falcons, Devin Fuller. Rookie ticket autograph, Devin Fuller. Falcons, that'll go to Justin Amendola. No relation to Danny from what we understand. Although we can pretend he is. Daniel Braverman, at a $199 playoff ticket autograph for the Bears. That goes out to Brian Sawyer. Andy Yanovich is your rookie ticket autograph for the Broncos. That'll go to Moody. Mothro thinks it's going to be close for both games. I can definitely see that. Legendary contenders. Kind of fly through these vet base that we're not shipping here. And we go to Will Fuller. There it is. Cracked ice sepia. Will Fuller, Texans for Arthur. 4 out of 24. Are you not entertained? Arthur, are you not entertained? There it is. 4 out of 24. Will Fuller on card autograph. Cracked ice. Sepia variation. Very nice one for Arthur Peru and the Texans. Yeah, I think that's why Dano was laughing, Arthur, because the Texans always seem to hit. They're always in there. Nice cracked ice. And there's Daniel Braverman again. For the Bears, going to Brian. Sterling Shepard, 10 out of 199, rookie of the year contenders for the Giants. That will go to Dave Marr. We got Trevor Davis. Rookie roundup autograph for the Packers. Trevor Davis may need to do some work this weekend. Tomorrow, actually, William Thomas. Packers. There you go. Pay attention to the road, Arthur. Come on now. All right. And here we go. Nice box. So Trevor Davis, Bears, Texans with a nice hit, Broncos, Bears again, and Falcons. Plus the Rookie of the Year Contenders card. All right, next box. Good luck, everybody. Carlos saying, Big Ben has been to 3 Super Bowls, 1-2. Indeed. He just needs to get there then, right? Standing in his way are the Patriots in Foxborough. Not exactly the easiest game to win. Trust me, I'm a Raiders fan. All right, here we go. Next box. Thanks for sticking here with me, folks. I'm a little under the weather today, so I've been pounding cold medicines. head's kind of fuzzy at the moment, so I apologize. Maybe going a little bit slower than I usually do. But I appreciate you guys hanging out with me here. Once this break is done, I believe we have a limited football, a third of a case break, a 5-box break of limited football already filled up. So we'll be doing that after this. At some point tonight, I will be doing the randomizer for the break credit, but that's going to take a minute or two, so I'll wait until if there ends up being a lull in the action, I will do that break credit randomizer later on. But coming up after this, after I clear this break away and everything,
will be the limited football break, so stick around for that. Which I believe, judging from the pace that we're going at, we should be done with this break in a little less than an hour at this point. Another 50 minutes or so. Jason McKee saying that Fuller autograph is going to be big money. If the Texans can, and this is coming from a Texans fan, he says, if the Texans can ever get a quarterback and if Will Fuller learns how to catch. Right, that's the chicken or the egg argument, right, Jason McKee? Can Fuller not catch because of the quarterback? Or is the or does the quarterback look bad because the wide receivers can't catch? Oh, the Brock Lobster. All right, here we go. Tannehill on top. Getting started. MVP contenders, AJ Green, Mackenzie Alexander. So those inserts will ship. Vet base like this are not going to be shipping, just FYI. Jason McKee says, I'm okay with blaming the Brock Lobster for everything at this point. Yeah, a lot of money paid to. I mean, listen, at that point, 74, 72, does it matter? At that point, no. It's a lot of money that went to the Brock Lobster. I think that's the point that Travis is trying to make. I mean, there's a lot of money for that guy. Eric Swoop, Colts. Although, listen, Texans management and front office has been saying, listen, you got to understand that even though the Brock Lobster has been in the league for a minute or two and had some starts here and there, he's essentially a rookie. He's got to learn a new system, be in a new city, you know, and has to learn to be the guy. So, you know, maybe we're being too hard on the Brock Lobster. Too hard, too early, you know what I mean? Give him another chance. At a 199, Johnny Holton for the Raiders. It's another one for Jason McKee. With my Raiders. I think I saw another Raider coming up, Jason. Oh, this is number two. That's pretty cool. Touchdown tandems. I feel like Rob Gronkowski has been missing a lot of playoffs, I think, due to injury. 41 out of 99. Tom Brady, Rob Gronkowski, touchdown tandems. If Gronk was healthy, I think it'd be easier to call that Steelers-Patriots game. Here's that other Raider. There's Connor Cook for Jason McKee. Rookie roundup on card auto. Nice. And yes, Jason McKee, you are starting a Johnny Holden PC. All right, looking for a couple more autographs. Here's another one. Jalen Smith auto for the Cowboys. That'll go to Jeremy Tillman. Legendary contenders for the Saints. And Cody Whitehair for the Bears. That will go to Brian Sawyer. Random numbers. Again, those will be randomized. Rookie of the Year. We saw Paxton Lynch yesterday. There's Jalen Richard. That'll go to the Raiders as well. Bengals cards asking, what will happen first? The Bengals winning a playoff game or the Browns making a playoff game? Maybe both cities will be waiting a little while for that one. Sup, JT? No, we have not seen any of the big names yet for the Cowboys. We had a Jalen Smith. I think there was a Malik Collins earlier. Maybe a couple other numbered cards off the top of my head. I don't really quite remember, but no, none of the big names yet. Oh, you're looking for a Carl Joseph, Jason McKee? Is he in this set? He is in this set, right? I think he's a redemption, actually. If I'm not mistaken. I think we've seen one or two of him. Okay. Mothro says he thinks Bengals will win their first playoff game. before the Browns make a playoff game?
Well, I don't know. I mean, Browns are an interesting situation, right? They started what? I think they started an unprecedented amount of rookies on their team. So they're essentially fielding a college team, I guess. So there's a lot of rookies on there, a lot of inexperienced players, you know, but they're racking up the draft picks, right? So at some point, if they're racking up those draft picks, they got to put themselves in a pretty good position, you know. I think the idea is you're sort of deconstructing the team in order to reconstruct it. But I mean, it's fun. It's easy to make fun of the Browns, but I think they're doing the, hey, we got to take a step backwards before we can start to take two steps forwards. You know, that might be it. They got to get some consistency in the head coaching there. They got to just be smarter about draft picks in the future. And I think with their new front office, I think that's kind of part of it. The Raiders had to do the same thing. Raiders had to go in there. They had to shed some bad contracts. I mean, they had still had to field a team, but they had to shed some bad contracts. They lost a lot of draft picks because of that Carson Palmer deal. So they had to collect draft picks, you know, and then stay over the floor of the salary cap, you know. So they had to do all that. But after Reggie McKenzie came over from the Packers and kind of deconstructed the team and then started to reconstruct the team, I think obviously Raiders fans are very happy to see the fruits of that labor and that sacrifice happening now. Ronbo, talking hobby a little bit. Anyone use a scanner to scan cards, or if they know of a good scanner for cards? He's not looking for a flatbed scanner, but something already card-sized. Does anyone have any advice for that? Okay, next box. Thanks for bearing with me, folks. A little under the weather right now, but trying to keep things going. There's out of 49, Brandon McManus, kicker auto, going out to the Broncos. That will be for Moody. Now, Arthur, I don't want you to crash while you're driving, but I think I saw a Texans auto coming up. Just be calm, be cool. But I think there's a Texans autograph coming up. Relax. Another Jalen Richard for Jason McKee. Here we go. Here it comes. Texans autograph. Easy, Arthur. Relax. Easy. Here it comes. There it is. There's Texans. There's Tyler Irvin. Let's see. Parallel? No, not a parallel, but a nice on-card auto. Tyler Irvin for the Houston Texans. Nice. There you go, man. It goes along with your cracked ice. Will Fuller. Actually, let me just put this right here so we can recap that at the end of the box. Legendary contenders, speaking of the Browns, they do have history. Oh, look at this. Cracked ice, Alex Smith. No ink, but it's just a season ticket card. Cracked ice. 4 out of 24. Nice. That is a nice one for the Chiefs. That goes to Travis Craig with the Chiefs. Alex Smith, not a bad... Everyone likes to make fun of Alex Smith, I think, but I think they have to keep him in Kansas City. Maybe give him someone a little bit better to throw to than Jeremy Maclin. You know what I mean? That could have been the difference in that game. That divisional game. Oh, that was not flipped or upside down, or that was not flipped around. There it is, right there. Chris Moore. Rookie ticket auto for Joe and the Ravens. Nice. Right on the card too, Joe. And what's this? Dual autograph. Nice. Both? We were just talking about the Browns. These guys might be the future of the Browns, right? Jordan Payton
And Rashad Higgins, 13 out of 99. That's your round numbers dual autograph. Both from the fifth round, I believe. It says right there. A lot of value comes in the fifth round, folks. In those later rounds, that's where the GMs make their money. You know, those later rounds, fourth, fifth, sixth. Dak Prescott, fourth rounder. That's where the GMs make their money. You know, first few rounds, I feel like, you know, it's relatively chalk, right? First few rounds, but the later rounds, that's where it's important. Jarrell Presley, Packers with that one, even though he has his Vikings gear on. Nice, Arthur. That is strong. Justin Burris, Jets. Sam says he's got me plugged into his sound system in his truck. He's got a couple of 12s in there bumping some Jaspies. I like that. Let the state of Arizona know, Sam. Let Arizona know that you're repping Jaspies. I like that. All right, Jets, Packers, the dual auto for the Browns, Ravens, Texans, and Broncos. So nice one, Sebastian, with the Cleveland Browns, that dual auto. It's very, very nice. And we got the cracked ice, Alex Smith. Mothra was asking, speaking of the Chiefs, Mothra was asking about, hey, what happened to Jamaal Charles? I think age and injury, Mothra. You know, that seems to catch up to running backs a little bit more quickly than any other position player. So I think that's eventually what caught up to Jamaal Charles. He played a little bit here and there last season, but looks like he is he's pretty close to the end of his career, which is kind of a shame. He's a beast, Jamaal Charles. But Jamaal Charles, you know, is being slowly replaced by two pretty comparable running backs. Spencer Ware is solid, and Chartrandrick West is a good change of pace. Those are two running backs that they have there that do pretty well, you know. But for Alex Smith, I think it just can't be throwing to Travis Kelce. Now, listen, Alex Smith isn't going to be throwing Aaron Rodgers style Hail Marys anytime soon. He's just not that sort of player. So if that's the case, you know, you got to surround Alex Smith with a little more weapons. It's just his outside receivers have just not been helping him out. Defense is still great, though. That defense is strong. I don't know. It'll be interesting to see what all these teams are going to be doing in the offseason. Because you got a number of teams that seem like they're just like a player or two away, right? A little luck here and there. Little bounce of the ball here and there, and you feel like there are a number of teams that could really take it to the next level. I feel like, you know, my in-division rivals, the Kansas City Chiefs, I feel like they're pretty close, you know. Maybe a full season of Tyreek Hill should be pretty interesting. Gotta have someone other than Jeremy Maclin, though. He's been regressing a little bit as a receiver. A lot of the guys here at Jaspy's are Eagles fans, of course, and I think they're very happy with their season. They got something nice out of Carson Wentz. They're happy about Carson Wentz, you know. But who else do you add to that team? They need receivers. Carson Wentz has to be able to throw to somebody now. You know, maybe shore up that running game a little bit, but their defense could be improved as well, but I think the key may be to add a couple nice weapons for Carson Wentz and look at the future of that running game too. Jason McKee says, I think the Titans will overtake the divisional champ. You know what? The Titans, you know, had a really nice season. If you look at the season that they had, Marcus Mariota has definitely taken to the next level. You know, they got DeMarco Murray, Derrick Henry, both of those running backs look great. You got DeJay Sharp coming up the ranks a little bit. You know, I think they might be like one solid, like big time receiver away
from really unlocking their offensive potential there, especially with the way their ability to balance out the running attack too, or balance out their offense with the running attack. You know, they're another couple drafts away, maybe a free agent signing or two, or in a couple drafts away from becoming a strong team, a playoff team. There's Jordan Payton, got his dual auto. Now you got his individual auto, Sebastian. Nice. Set this right here, and you see the other autograph already. Might as well show you. It's Cameron Brate for the Buccaneers. Jerry Bennington with that one. Legendary contenders. Niners are holding open tryouts, says Dano. Oh, I should try out for QB, huh? Yeah, I don't know if they're gonna do that. I don't know if they want. I mean, even for a QB, my 40 time isn't very good. Darian Thomas. That goes to the New York Football Giants. Dave Marr with that one. The round numbers right here. Playoff ticket, CJ Anderson out of 249. Moody with the Broncos. Let's set that over here. We're almost done with this, folks. We're getting there. Legendary contenders. Rookie of the year contender. We saw Kenneth Dixon, 15-9. I saw him yesterday. And he broke some limited boxes with us. And limited is actually what we're going to be doing next after this. Sterling Shepard, nice autograph right on the card. New York Football Giants, Dave Marr with that Sterling Shepard. Giants, too. Giants are also on the cusp of being able to take it to the next level. Yeah, McKee is saying Mariota is like, what, 30 touchdowns and zero interceptions in the red zone? That's insane. Yeah, Marcus Mariota has proven to be a very very efficient quarterback. Buccaneers going out to Jerry with that one. And a redemption. Who could that be? All right. The redemption is Alex Collins. He was there at the event yesterday. Alex Collins. Rookie ticket RPS variation going out to Alexander Lahm and the Seahawks. Yep, limited will be after this. We should be able to break that in about half an hour or so, Joe. This is kind of a long break, so it's going to take a little more time. In about 30, 40 minutes, we'll be doing the next limited football, which is already filled. Then after that, I have no idea what we're doing after that. I'm a little under the weather, folks, so we're going to see how far I can make it tonight. Seahawks, Buccaneers, Giants, Buccaneers, and Browns. Nice. A couple of these cards right here, too. All right, so we have four boxes left. Good luck, everybody. At least 20 autographs to go in this. So we're getting there. Do you want to do the football mixer tonight? That's like a two-hour break. Hey, if it fills, we'll do it, I guess. That spot randomizer has to go first, though, Dano. I have to keep reminding everybody that we have a few spots in each mixer locked away in the spot randomizer. So let's fill up the spot randomizer first. Then we can start talking mixers. Don't forget, spot random 22 on the website right now. $60 can get you a high-end mixer spot. Look at the high-end mixers on the website, folks. We are going to break those this week. Might be able to do one tonight, actually. Either one tonight, or we can definitely do something next week.
but we got to fill up that mixer for or the not again. It has been locked away for the last 2 weeks. That spot randomizer has been there. We've just had a lot of new releases and a lot of stuff. We haven't been able to push that as much, but yeah, that mixer has been in that spot randomizer for a while. So let's get that one filled up first. I would do that. In the spot randomizer, number 22, the top four prizes are a spot in each of those high-end mixers. So there's one for the multi-sport, one for the baseball, one for the basketball, one for the football. And so $60 can get you randomized into one of those slots. So you can get a mixer spot for a fraction of the price. Yeah, Danny, you should be able to watch and chat on YouTube as well. You've always been able to chat on YouTube. Now, the spot randomizer 22, going back to that, on JaspysHobbyland.com. So the top four prizes, I think, are the mixer spots. Now the rest of the spots are not spots into breaks. They're actual autographs from Vault Originals baseball. So if you get if you don't get any of those mixer spots, there'll be if you don't get a mixer spot, you'll get a guaranteed 5x7 autograph. Joe, yeah, the mixer is a whole amalgamation, a whole combination of different football products all thrown into one. Yeah, we have a whole list of all the boxes that are in that mixer. In there, $60 is high-end stuff too. I think it's mostly high-end stuff. That's why the mixer itself is on the pricey side. Legendary Contenders, nice. LaDainian Tomlinson out of 99, going to the Chargers. Just talking about Mariota a moment ago. Chargers car, that'll go to Jeremy Merle. And we've got a $60 football mixer, high-end football mixer. We've got a multi-sport mixer that's also high-end, high-end baseball and high-end basketball mixer. So there are four monster mixers that I know have been on the site for a while, but we gave away a lot of those spots in our Jaspy's holiday season extravaganza, and a lot of people have just straight up buying them. You know, and so We'll get those done. Don't worry about it, folks. We'll get those done. Glenn Gronkowski, Patriots. We knew they were going to take a little bit of time, but we're getting there. Michael G with that one. What's up, Daniel? Oh, Danny made it into the YouTube stream. He says, oh, this is way better than Breakers. Well, there you go, man. See? Most of our crew's been chatting in here pretty much the entire time. Most of our crew's been in there. Abil. Nice. 19 out of 25, Ronbo. There you go. Cardell Jones right on the card. Championship ticket auto. There you go. See? Arthur and Ronbo, who were really worried they weren't going to hit. Well, Arthur got a cracked ice, and Ronbo got a nice Cardell Jones championship ticket out of 25. Nice. More points, which we'll randomize to everybody in the break. Legendary Contenders. Arthur's like, see? Complaining mojo works. Sometimes it does. Cody Core, Bengals. Rookie Roundup autograph for the Bengals going out to Peter Eng. There you go, Peter. Got some touchdown tandems right here. Hope to see more of that next season for the Raiders, for my Raiders. More legendary contenders. That'll go to the Titans. Nice. 45 out of 199 touchdown tandems. Panthers had a weird year. 45 out of 199. There it is. Cam Newton, Calvin Benjamin. They just didn't seem to be clicking from the beginning of the season onward, so... Sheldon Rankin, Saints, rookie ticket autograph going out to Matthew Viss. And the last bits of this box
I think that's it for the autos. Yeah, and then a round number card, which we'll randomize. These cards we don't need.
Yeah, the only thing is that there's no the lag is a little bit longer, Daniel. So between Breakers and YouTube, the lag will be a little bit longer. So it'll take it'll seem slightly longer for you to write something in the chat and then for me to end up responding. And there's no PMing, and there's no links in the chat. Two things which I like a lot. There's your Cardell Jones. There's only four in this one? Yeah, I didn't miss an auto, right? No, I don't think I missed an auto. I guess there's only four in that one. It happens on average. Yeah, it's great, Ronbo, isn't it? People not being able to drop links. And then people not being able to IM me. It's fantastic. Yeah, it looks like there was a missing auto. That was kind of annoying. Yeah, I thought there was gonna be one more, but I didn't see it. Am I losing my mind? No. Yeah.
Well, on average.
Oh, there was a points card, right, Sebastian? You're right. There was that points card, 250. Remember? That takes place of the auto. It was 250. It was one. It was 250, I think. It was red. 150 was earlier. Yeah, I kind of lost my mind there too, Thomas. I was like, wait a second, we got shorted an auto, Panini. But no, oh yeah, those points usually replace an auto in there. Oh yeah, linking checklists would be nice for other people to link. Okay, so there's a downfall there. If you're in the YouTube channel, folks, double check, and I guess if you're in the Breakers.tv stream as well, double check to make sure you have you're subscribed, that you're subscribed to our YouTube channel. That way you'll know exactly when we go on air, and you'll never miss a break, never miss a video. We have some fun videos from yesterday with a couple NFL players, Kenneth Dixon and Tyler Boyd. Oh, okay, about Select Saw. Well, what was it about, Daniel? Was there something I could answer here? Or if it was a shipping issue, then I wouldn't be able to help you, but... Yeah, Arthur, you and Ron got a couple nice autos out of there too. I just need to get Ron one more auto, Arthur, and you guys will both have two. Well, you got a horizontal one, Ron. That's nice, right? Yeah, you both got variations. But here's the other thing, Ron. I think was Arthur's cracked ice a sticker auto? I don't know. Actually, look. Now I'm curious because yours was on card. No, it was on card. Arthur's was on card. Oh my god, the camera almost died. Okay, there you go. Oh, no shipping. Oh, you're coming to the store. Yeah, nice, Daniel. Where do you live again? I forget where you live. Where do you live again? What are you doing in the... Oh, you're picking up your cards. Okay, cool. Yeah, thanks for emailing us on that. Where do you live again? Are you here for business or fun with family? Jalen Smith. Cracked ice variation. 9 out of 24. Jalen Smith auto. This one's a sticker auto for some reason. But anyway, that goes to Jeremy Tillman. Right, you're all the way out up there in Canada, right? Well, it'll be nice to have you here. What day are you visiting? Now, vacation and family, says Dan.
When are you visiting again? What are the dates? I just want to make sure that I'm here. No autograph, Joe Callahan. Womp, 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 womp. Come on, Joe. William Thomas with the Packers. 18th through 21st on February. Is that what days are those? Is it like Monday through or Tuesday through something? Jordan Payton, Browns. Another one for Sebastian. Touchdown tandems. I believe that no autograph card actually sells kind of well on a secondary market. Adam Humphries for the Buccaneers auto going out to Jerry. Gotta send that out. And Josh Doctson. Horizontal out of 24. Cracked ice. Right on the card as well. This has been a nice case, folks. Redskins going out to Michael G. That's a nice hit. Nice Josh Doctson. I believe he was at the event the last couple days too. MVP contenders. David Johnson, definitely an MVP contender. Rookie of the Year. Save those round numbers cards. Derrick Henry. We'll send that Jonathan Williams out to you too, Ronbo, if you want to try that out. Darian Thomas, New York Football Giants. Autograph going to Dave Marr. I think I've got like four cracked ice in this case, Dano. And Warren Moon, legendary contenders. 104 out of 199 Oilers. That'll go to the Titans, Jeremy Merle. Oh, so there you go, Ron. Nice. Little bonus for you. Okay, so we got those. That was the end of the box. Two more to go, folks. We're almost done. Thanks for your patience, folks. We still got 10 autographs to go, Jason. We'll see. This is already a great case. Could be even a better case. Okay, so here's what was in that box right there. So there were two cracked ice horizontal variations in that box. Redskins and Cowboys. What I understand happened with Joe Callahan, I believe it's when I believe it's when he either didn't return cards or he didn't do sticker autos. He didn't do something. He dropped the ball, basically. I'm pretty sure that's what it is. Oh, Ronbo in the Breakers.tv stream. You wanna summarize that for me, Ron? Beckett had done a little article on it. All right, two more to go. I think that's what the case is. It might be a different one. It might be a different case this year. What was the deal this year? How much are the no autos worth? I have no idea. Just check eBay, Brian, but oh, I see. There you go. So, however, neither quote from that Beckett article, and however, neither signed their cards, likely to prevent confusion as to why all the other rookie tickets have autographs and these don't. A large foil stamp noting the lack of ink was added to both cards. There you go. And this should prevent aftermarket autographs being added as well. There you go. See? Yeah, so that's what happens when you don't sign your cards. Or you don't sign the stickers for those cards. You get the womp, 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 womp. No autograph sticker or no autograph foil stamp on there. No big Jason Lee's asking any big Cowboy hits. I'm assuming you mean Dak Prescott or Ezekiel Elliott. There was a big Cowboy hit. It was a cracked ice variation of like Jalen Smith, I think, but
I don't think that's what people are asking when they're asking about big Cowboys hits. So no, no Dak Prescott, no Ezekiel Elliott, but there was a horizontal variation, cracked ice for the Cowboys, which was still pretty cool. All right, two boxes ago. We are almost done, folks. We're getting there. Jason said, oh, Smith will be huge next year? Oh. Cowboys also had a fantastic season this year. So they're on the right track, folks. Where does Tony Romo go? I would just trade Tony Romo for whatever draft picks I can get. If Cowboys keep adding through the draft, I mean, they already got these players now, adding through the draft. You know, they'll have a lot of money to spend. They'll have a lot of money to spend in free agency once they start shedding some contracts. The Cowboys are going to be a very scary position, very dangerous position to strike and be a big team for a long time. All right, second to last box. Here we go. Will Fuller. Another Will Fuller. On card auto for Arthur and the Texans. Nice one, Arthur. The Leonti Carew will send out. Jeremy Cash for the Panthers. That will go to Ryan. There you go, Ryan. Ryan Grobman with that one. Rookie of the Year contender, Ezekiel Elliott. Yeah, Jason saying they have heart. Even in the loss, they looked good. I think they did too. They came out a little flat in the first half, but the way they battled back. Another Jordan Payton for Sebastian. A lot of Browns in here. Got that dual auto again earlier. Nice legendary contenders. Ed Reed, that's to 99 for Joe. And another Panther for Ryan. James Bradbury. Who was talking about you? Crabtree. Richard Sherman out of 249 for the Seahawks. Going to Alexander. Todd Gurley. And we've got a Kavari Russell autograph. Rookie ticket auto for the Bengals. Going out to Peter Eng. There you go, Pete. Moody saying Broncos should trade Paxton Lynch and develop Trevor Siemian, huh? Adam K looking for the complaint mojo. He's wondering if there's been any not seen any Rams yet, Adam. Maybe. Yeah, there's got to be like a Farrell Cooper hiding in there somewhere, right? That makes sense. All right. Well, we got 5 to 6 autographs to go, so let's see. So here's what we had in that last box, or the second to last box. Nice. A couple of these guys too, which are pretty cool. Nice. What's my Super Bowl prediction, Brian? Well, I have to find out who's going to be in the Super Bowl first. I don't know who's going to be in the Super Bowl yet, Brian. How am I supposed to give you a Super Bowl prediction? McKee thinks that Siemian has a lower ceiling than Paxton Lynch. Yeah, Paxton Lynch is pretty cool. We got to hang out with Paxton Lynch a little bit yesterday
at the NFLPA Collegiate Bowl, Panini was doing their rookie closeout, and GTS was doing their rookie closeout, which was great to be at, thanks to Panini and GTS. And Paxton Lynch was hanging around, and he was talking about how he used to collect, and how he used to collect Pokemon cards. So he said he used to have like binders and sleeves of like Pokemon cards when he was a kid. I thought that was great. We got a nice laugh out of that. All right, Moody is arguing that, hey, listen, Paxton has a gun, but in the NFL, sometimes the raw tools just doesn't mean you develop into a high-caliber player. It's true. Yeah, it's a risk, certainly, every time. Well, look at Alex Smith. Alex Smith doesn't necessarily have a gun. The Niners kind of gave up on him, and now Alex Smith, you know, maybe not the sexiest, you know, thrower out there, gunslinger out there, but, you know, seems to be more than effective as a quarterback. Yeah, it's a combination of a lot of things. I mean, if it was easy to project Moody and everybody, if it was easy to project who's going to be, you know, a great one or not, man, we'd all have scouting jobs, right? Brian, Steelers are... yeah, we were talking about this earlier, Brian. I mean, for me personally, for the AFC Championship, I'd like to see the Steelers win. You know, me being a longtime Raiders fan, you know, there's a lot of reason for me to be salty about the Patriots. So I'm pulling for the Steelers. Well, I'm pulling for good games. I think no matter who ends up in the Super Bowl, it's going to be, I think it's going to be a great game. And back to the NFC, I don't know. I like both teams, so it's hard for me to pick one of them. I think my heart says the Packers, but if my wallet was betting, I think I'd go with Falcons. But I like both of those teams a lot. All right, last box, everybody. We made it. Thanks, everyone. There's Khalil Mack Attack out of 249, playoff ticket. Nice one, Jason. That is what she said, Arthur. Yeah, hey, Moody's like, hey, keep as many QBs as you can afford. Too many injuries in the modern game. It's true. I think I was listening to a podcast last week. Ronnie Staley, or Stanley for the Ravens, another one for Joe. And I was listening to a podcast with – I don't know if people listen to the Fantasy Focus podcast. But Stefania Bell from ESPN is on the Fantasy Focus podcast with Matthew Berry, and she has a separate podcast that she does every once in a while called Answering the Bell. And recently she had forget who the doctor was, not James Andrews, but someone else who's the top foot and ankle doctor out there. He did the surgery on Marcus Mariota's fibula. I think he's working on Julio Jones's turf toe and whatnot. And he was saying one of the big issues for all these injuries in the modern game today is a lot of turf changes. I think a lot of stadiums, believe it or not, have some form of artificial turf. Shoes are different. There's Jared Goff. Autograph. There it is, Adam K. Yeah, I guess the complaint mojo did work today. 13 out of 25, Jared Goff on-card autograph for Adam K. Whoa, hockey with that one. Nice. So shoes is also an issue. Different shoes. And guys are playing more year-round. So guys are training a lot more year-round. Another Jordan Payton for Sebastian. I mean, is that five Jordan Paytons for you now? You're starting your Jordan Payton PC, Sebastian. And that dual auto, too. So all that combined, you know what I mean? All of that combined, well, that adds to more injuries over time. There's Dak Prescott, gold ink for the Cowboys. I believe that's actually going for something. Leonti Carew. On card auto to 99 for the Dolphins. That will go out to who does that go out to? That goes out to Last Spot Mojo, Matt. Nice. Yeah, so I think it's a lot of those issues combined for Moody and for everybody. Why we're seeing a lot more injuries these days. Basketball too. Back in the day, people were saying, you know, the ball players, basketball players would take summers off. They wouldn't play basketball. They would do something else. But now, basketball, they train year round. Now, that does make for better product on the court, you know, Daryl Worley, but you're also seeing more injuries too, earlier and more often as well. That's part of it. Cross training is important. I know anybody who works out a certain degree or used to be an athlete or something like that, cross training, you know, is really important. But a lot of times you just people do a sport and they specialize it, and so do all these specialized workouts for it. A lot of early injuries. Well, I didn't get injured in this break, ladies and gentlemen, so thanks for doing this with me. Really appreciate it. I only have one randomizer to do. None of those round numbers cards were actually numbered, so we can do this. Panthers, Dolphins, Browns, and a nice Jared Goff for Adam at the end, who's happy. He got worried a little bit there. And then there's the Ravens. Jared Goff was at the event yesterday. We didn't get to run into him, though. There's that. And let's do a couple quick randomizers, right? Or one randomizer right here. Just the left, right. Oh, I got to randomize points, too. And Super Bowl squares. That's right. So I do have some work to do here. Okay. So let's randomize these guys off. And we'll do the Super Bowl squares and the points in one big list right there. All right. Hey, thanks, Moody. You're welcome, man. Appreciate you getting in. Appreciate everybody in this break. Listen, whether you guys hit or not, I appreciate you guys keeping me company in a long break like this, hanging out with me, enjoying the breaks. There are winners, there are losers, but I appreciate everybody's orders just the same. So thank you very much. All right, so let's do the left right on those round numbers cards, left and right. And now we got to give away points and Super Bowl squares. So in our item description, we said two Super Bowl squares. Nice. So let's take everybody here. So from William and the Cardinals down to Michael G and the Redskins. So here's how we'll do it. The two names on top, right, will get Super Bowl squares. So person one at the end of the randomizer, Super Bowl square. Second person, Super Bowl square. Third person, 250 points. Fourth person, 250 points. And the fifth person, 150 points. So that's how we'll do it. Okay, so good luck. One dice roll for both lists. Good luck, everybody. Three easy times. One and a two. Three easy times. One, two, and three. Left side for that one. Left side. So on the left side right there, all the left side teams will be getting those round number cards. And then once again, three times for the, nope, not that screen. This screen right here. Welcome back. So one and a two, three times. I clicked the wrong button. Three times for the all the names. One, two, and third and final time. So William and Jerry, you guys get Super Bowl squares. Ed gets 250 points. William, 250 points, and Sebastian, along with all of your Jordan Payton autos, 150 points coming your way. So there you go. One, two, three, four, five. Thank you very much, everybody. This is Joe for JaspysHobbyland.com. Thanks so much. Bye.